The air and fuel mixture will sprinkle down into there, and explosions will happen, and great things will follow. Maybe. Here's a perfectly good intake that's not really doing anything for me because it didn't fit, so I think I'm going to take my Sawzall now and cut it apart. I should have graduated school. Alright, after a day of mild arts and crafts and aluminum shavings stuck between my teeth, here's what I've got going on. I've got my base plate. Sets up in here. Going to get welded on, permanently attached. Then, I've got a base plate for my car, which will not sit on top like that. It will set up in the sky above that. Then very simply, I'll route all 8 tubes to the carburetor nice and neatly. And I punch the numbers into my computer. My computer says it's gonna be badass and work quite well. Hopefully my computer model's not wrong. I may be simple, but I ain't no pimple. I have made my own intake manifold. I didn't need to order some specially made, custom, fancy piece of crap. I just made my own specially custom made piece of crap. So here it is. Finished. Bolts are out, and I haven't moved it yet. I'm gonna lift it up and see if it actually is removable. And it's removable. Today's your first day pedaling. Go, Nate, go, Nate, go, 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 go.
Zach, you're a bike?
Yeah. Come on, pedal, 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 pedal. Yeah, buddy. Yeah, buddy. You're doing it. Don't stop. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. All right. Woo!
What are you doing?
Making a movie. Who are you? What do? All right.
Whee!
Come on, boy. How old are you?
5.
How long you been riding bikes?
I don't know. A couple days.
Couple days and you're already a pro. I got a biker gang.
I'm not a pro. I'm a genius.
Not a pro. He's a genius. This engine stand was built in China last year. I'm a little bit afraid it's gonna tip over, and that's a small block on it. This engine stand, on the other hand, was built by my brother in 8th grade metal shop. What's wrong with the world? Now, if we backtrack in my story a little bit, I got a little scared about my fuel injection setup while I was putting this motor together, and I sent it to an expert, right? Because I wanted some expert help. I wanted my motor to actually work. I was a little bit scared to do something I'd never done before. Seemed a little too complicated, a lot of wiring, a lot of bullcrap. I didn't really want to do it, so I tried to pawn it off on somebody else. When he got the motor, he says, well, the lifters and the rockers are a little bit pitted. I know they move, and to me, you know, if they move, it'll work. But no, you gotta spend money and get these things custom made. You gotta get you some special stuff. It'll take 12 months, but it'll be worth it. The guy spends my money. Bunch of money spent on these custom rockers and lifters and push rods that he says I need. Then he holds on to this stuff, never puts the motor together, Stopped by a bunch of times. Hey, you working on the motor? No. You gonna work on it? Yeah. Never happens. After 2 years or more, I get tired of my motor sitting there. I bring it home and it sits here for a little while I dream about it. And then I get to putting it together. And all I got is this box of rockers and push rods. And it's time to put it together, right? I spent the money. I got this nice fancy stuff. Guess why the guy never worked on my motor? Because he ordered me the wrong parts and he didn't want to man up and fucking deal with it. I put the fucking... all the intakes in, right? Because the exhausts are all the same and the intake, the rocker arms are different. Put them all in, and the whole time I'm putting them in, I'm going, man, these push rods are awful close to the heads when they come up and down. They're really close. And then I put them all in and I go turn the motor over and the motor won't turn over. The motor won't turn over because these push rods are all pressed up against the head. So the guy spent a bunch of my money and ordered the wrong parts. Didn't want to be a man about it and just decided to let it sit on the shelf. Pretend like, oh, nothing's wrong, I just don't have time. Thank you so much. This is why I do everything myself. Well, one of the reasons I do everything myself. The other reason is because as crazy as it might be to think that somebody as unskilled as me might put a motor together, if it ever actually works, well, I'm just king of the world because I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm going to make this bitch work. Now I'm going to take all these push rods out, make sure the motor actually turns over, which it should. Turned over when I gave it to the dude. It's got oil in it. Everything should be fine. The motor should turn over. Then I got to dig into my pile of old parts that the guy said was no good and see if the old push rods that I had will in fact work. Hopefully they do. If not, I got to do my least favorite thing and try and figure out what the hell I need. Deal with the experts, the so-called experts of the world. We really do deserve China. Now this motor should turn over with a breaker bar. I should be able to turn it by hand around and around all day long without running into any hard spots. You see here, I'm turning, and then nothing, locks up. Go the other way, turning, locks up. The push rods are rubbing up against the head. I know they are. But I'm just going to double check my theory. And then we can really go ahead and blast this fucking piece of shit motherfucker. Non-skilled, untalented, fucking bitch of a man that can't fucking take responsibility for his fucking mistakes. You make a fucking mistake, you're supposed to be a fucking expert getting paid to do a fucking job. And you can't fucking do it. My buddy's one of these people just living on a fucking... on the government fucking handouts. Just living on the government handouts and then occasionally robbing people that come in for fucking quality motor work. Leave with a bunch of shit that doesn't work because the fucking guy didn't order the right parts. Motherfucker. No wonder when I was saying, hey, I know you had this thing for 2 years. Of course I didn't say this. You know, you had the fucking thing for 2 years and you just stared at it. By the way, do I owe you anything? Oh, no, you don't owe me anything. Yeah, wonder why. Because all the fucking money you spent... He was paid for his time to order parts. But, you know, I was just being generous. Like, you know, I'm just taking this job away from you now because you're a fucking dickbag. You know, do I owe you anything for having my motor sit in your shop? Oh, no, you're fine. You don't owe me nothing. Yeah, no shit. Because you knew damn well that shit wouldn't work. Fucking lie right to your goddamn face, you motherfucker. Motherfucker is way too nice of a term for somebody that fucks you over. A motherfucker is a nice term. I'm a motherfucker. I don't know what this fucking mother shit fuck is. Alright. All the intakes are out now. Oh, surprise, surprise. The motor turns over now. I could stand here all day and turn this motor over. I got one exhaust push rod in, so. Ah. Blah 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 blah. Okay. So that's it. Wonderful. Lovely. These push rods are too fat and they don't work. So what I got here, I got push rods that are very nearly the same length as the fat ones. just a hair shorter. Seems okay, but I put it in. I just put one in, and it still rubs. Motor won't turn over. So now I know that at least some of these rocker arms are just wrong and they need to be replaced. It's just throwing this push rod way too close to the side of the head. It needs to be over here some. There's nothing I can do about that besides dig into my pile of rocker arms and see what I've got that might work. So surprise, surprise. The original rocker arms and push rods worked. What a waste. Now, I got to looking on the shelf for all my old parts, and it turns out I've only got half of them. So now what to do? Throw a brick through somebody's window, I suppose, and go take what's mine. You know, I don't pretend to know how to read a micrometer, but when you pretend you know how, you're a sick fucking... You're a fucking... The scourge of society pretends they know how to do something and takes your money. Maybe I'm the scourge of society. Maybe they're just outright thieves. It's fucked up. Pisses me off. I'm in a fucking mood now. I'm in a motherfucking mood now. I've got the valve train together, using four old rockers and all my old lifters. Actually, half the old lifters. Not lifters, push rods. You know, the lifter pushes the push rod pushes the rocker. I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about, you know? I'm gonna get some of these terms right and I'm gonna get some of them wrong. What are you gonna do? I got the basic idea. The motor turns around, things lift up, things push down, things go together, explosions happen, and things move. If it all comes together right. That's not the point of this. The point of this is using a bunch of the old parts, which I was supposed to throw away, and a bunch of the new parts, which I paid way too much money for, I have got the motor turning over again. But I got a lot of spots where the push rods are way too close to the head for comfort. So I'm going to mark these spots. I'm going to turn the motor around slow, mark all the spots I think are too close. Then I'm going to get in there with a grinder or a Dremel and make bigger tunnels and canals. What else am I supposed to do? This bitch is going to work. If it works for 10 seconds or if it works for 10 years, we're going to find out. Much better. So when I bought this cursed thing here, I had to hear about how expensive this damn oil pan was. And I'm going to have a lot of fun taking a cutoff wheel and just chopping it into 25 different pieces and putting it back together. I don't give a fuck if this oil pan was made out of gold. It doesn't fucking work. You know, I get to turning the motor over because I got to figure out what the fuck I'm going to do with an oil pump and an oil filter is not there. And the fucking goddamn, here I find out, first of all, the bitch hangs over the fucking bolts. It's nice. You hold a lot of fucking oil in your oil pan. Well, what a fucking pain in the ass. You can't get in there to all these bolts. And here I am motherfucking this thing. And I get back here to the back of the block. And here this goddamn pan is glued over top of the starter bolts. And then this bitch, this fucking overhang. So my question to you is how the fuck did they start this motor if this pan was on there? Either this pan doesn't belong on this fucking motor, I know what the fuck it belongs on, or the guy that made it never actually made it work. Maybe that's how I got this motor. Maybe the guy built the fucking oil pan and realized that it wasn't gonna work and he gave up and hung himself. I don't know. Or maybe there's a special starter that just hangs off the side of your engine block with one bolt.
fuck.
Either way, I'm cutting it. Well, I don't know what to do. I just do the same thing I do with everything else. I'm gonna make this bitch work. Here I am. Out here in the sauna, it's 122 degrees, and I'm gonna make this bitch work. I don't give a fuck what it takes. Time to cut stuff apart. I'm gonna draw some lines on it and chop it up, weld it back together, and make it work. You might as well hang out and watch. Let's see what's going on under here these days. It's always good when you're doing motor work to have a mason's hammer handy.